Hello everyone. In this lecture, we will study Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, which tells us that the rate of change of magnetic flux through a loop induces electromotive force. Mathematically, E is equal minus, minus derivative of phi V, where E is the electromotive force and phi V is the magnetic flux. We can expand this equation by replacing E by E dot EL and phi V with B dot EA, where phi V is the magnetic flux. And magnetic flux is the total number of magnetic field lines passing through a given closed surface. It depends on the strength of magnetic field, the area of the surface, and the angle between perpendicular to the area and magnetic field. Here, these two quantities, derivative of B and electric field, gives us very important results. It means whenever there is change in magnetic field, we will always get electric field. So it means changing magnetic field creates electric field. This negative sign means that the direction of induced electromotive force is always such as to oppose the change that causes it. This is called Lenz law. There are a few factors that affects electromotive force. The first one is number of turns in a coil. It means more turns in the coil, greater current induced. And the second one is the relative motion between the coil and the magnetic field. It means if the relative motion between the coil and the magnetic field is increased, the current in the conductor increases. And the third one is it depends on the strength of the magnetic field. The greater the magnetic field creates a bigger current in the conductor. And the final one is the area of the conductor on which the electromotive force also depends on. Let's have a look few cases due to which we can understand the Faraday's law. The first one, consider a wire placed in a magnetic field of permanent magnet, and also this wire is connected to galvanometer. When wire is at rest, galvanometer shows no current. When it moves from left to right, galvanometer shows current. When it moves from right to left, the galvanometer shows current again, but this time in opposite direction. In the second case, when bar magnet is at rest, no current is at the galvanometer, but when magnet moves towards coil, galvanometer indicates current. When it moves away from the coil, galvanometer shows again current, but this time in opposite direction. In third case, figure A shows that no current is induced in the coil of constant area. Please note that the coil is placed in uniform magnetic field and magnetic field is into screen. Now, if we rotate the coil, its area will reduce and induced current will appear on the galvanometer, as you can see in this figure. In the fourth case, current is also induced when a coil of constant area is rotated in a uniform magnetic field. This is the basic principle of AC generator. In the fifth case, consider a two coil, A and B. And if we close the switch of coil A, current is induced in coil B. The current comes down to zero when switch is open. Due to change in current, magnetic flux linked up with the coil A changes, and this changing flux induces current in coil B. And here is the sixth case in which both coil and electromagnet are stationary, but by changing the current of the electromagnet, the flux through coil is changed. And as a result, current is induced in the coil. That's all for today's lecture. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel and share with your friends.